This video is about active high-pass filters. It corresponds to section 24.3 in applied analog electronics. Now, active high-pass filter is going to be an active filter, so it needs an amplifier. And we're going to have two inputs. One of them will have a resistor and a capacitor in series. The other one will just be coming from VREF. And notice that the input here is always going to be on the negative side for active high-pass filters, because usually when we're doing a high-pass filter, we're trying to block DC. We want to have a gain of zero at 0 hertz. And if we had swapped these things so that we were using a non-inverting configuration, then we would have had a gain of at least one at DC. And since we don't usually want that for high-pass filters, we're just going to always use the inverting configuration. So we have a feedback resistor, we have an input resistor, and an input capacitor. The gain is just going to be minus ZF over ZI, which is minus RF over RI plus 1 over J omega CI. And because I don't like the J omega CI on the bottom, we can multiply top and bottom by that and get minus J omega RF CI over J omega RI CI plus 1. Okay, so we're going to get a corner frequency here that depends on RICI. So corner frequency is going to be 1 over 2 pi RICI. The gain in the passband, well, the passband here is where omega is very large. And so this plus 1 essentially disappears, the J omega cancels, and so the gain in the passband is going to be just minus RF over RI. Else cancels. So, all right, so let's do an example of this. Let's say we were looking for a corner frequency of about 1 kilohertz. Well, 1 kilohertz would give us a time constant, RICI, of about 159 microseconds. I'm not going to bother getting out my calculator for that. And let's pick, say, RI equals 15 kiloohms, CI, well, that would then have to be about 10 nanofarads to get coming out to maybe 150 microseconds rather than 160. And now we need to pick RF, and let's pick something so we get a pretty large gain for this one. Let's say RF is 1 megaohm. So the gain, all right, 1 megaohm over 15 kiloohms. That one I don't want to do in my head. That's going to be about minus 66.67, or if you prefer that in decibels, take the log base 10 and multiply by 20. That's about 36.5 dB. Okay, so I actually built this circuit with VREF being set to half my power supply voltage. I had a 5-volt power supply, so I was setting it to 2.5 volts. I had 10 nanofarads, 15 kiloohms, and 1 megaohm. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to waveforms and test this active filter. I'm putting in on channel 1, I'm looking at the input to the filter. On channel 2, I'm looking at the output of the filter. I'm using the network analyzer to excite the filter. And here I'm using a 20 millivolt input here, offset by 2.5 volts, because that's the center voltage for my amplifier. The offset here really doesn't matter because that capacitor is blocking the DC offset. So I could have put almost anything on here, and it wouldn't really matter. However, I do have on channel 2, an offset of 0 volts because I'm measuring channel 2 with respect to that 2.5 volts that I put in on the VREF. All right, so let's just do a single run of this from 30 hertz to 3 megahertz. And I'm doing this plot here in decibels, and it should get up to about 36.5 decibels at the peak, and it should get that corner frequency a little above 1 kilohertz. Wait a second. We are not getting a flat high-pass filter. We're getting something that looks like a bandpass filter. And there's a good reason for that. I was doing this thing with an MCP6004 op-amp chip, and those have a gain bandwidth product of only 1 megahertz. And so if you take a look at where this is coming back down to 0 dB, it's about at 1 megahertz. This downward slope that you're seeing here, that's due to the gain bandwidth limitations of the op-amp. So there's an inherent low-pass filter built into every op-amp. So when you're designing an active high-pass filter, you have to remember that you've got a low-pass filter built into the op-amp. And so the peak here, let's turn the cursor on, the peak here, which is right where the phase goes through 180 degrees, because that's where we actually get a real gain, it's 36.2627 dB, pretty close to the 36.5 dB that we calculated it should be. But it doesn't stay there for very long, because pretty soon we hit the low pass limitations of the op-amp from the gain bandwidth product. We can take a look for where it's 3 dB down from that. So that'll be at about 30, we want it about 33.2 hertz, somewhere around here. And it's about 1.24 kilohertz. And that's not too far off from where we expected the corner frequency to be. So our filter seems to be working correctly. You can see that at the very low frequencies, it's behaving like a capacitor. And at very high frequencies, we've got the low pass filtering of the op amp. And only in a fairly narrow range here do we actually have it, the passband that we expected to get from designing this thing as if it was a very high, an ideal op amp, which has high gain and keeps that gain at all frequencies. Okay, I think that's all I really wanted to tell you about active high pass filters. Generally, in this class, we'll be doing them at fairly low corner frequencies because we'll be using them for things like getting rid of DC but wanting to let through low frequency physiological signals like heartbeats. And so we're going to be using corner frequencies down around 1 hertz, not around 1 kilohertz. And so you'll be seeing several decades of the flat high pass before we get into the limitations of the op amp. So this one I picked was sort of pushing the limits for what the op amp could do. Partly because I asked for very high gain. I was asking for a gain of 67 here. And that's a pretty high gain. It means that those low pass filtering of the op amp comes in pretty soon. If you ask for less gain, you don't get that limitation till higher frequencies. And if you're only interested in lower frequencies, then it doesn't matter so much what's happening up here at the high frequencies. Okay.